Okay, right here is an Ingersoll Rand DM3 blast drill. Now, this machine is actually the second in the first two series of blast drills launched by Ingersoll Rand when the company first entered the blast drill market in 1948. To tell you a little quick history, the first blast drill launched by Ingersoll Rand was the company's Quarrymaster series. And the Quarrymaster technically wasn't a rotary blast drill. It was actually more of what was called a drifter. Now, I'm really not going to get into explaining what a drifter-style drill is, being that it's irrelevant to this machine, and there's a lot to talk about with just that topic. But later on in 1955, Ingersoll Rand introduced its Drillmaster series, which include the models DM1, DM2, and the DM3, which you see right here. All were small rotary blast drills, and were basically an upgraded, improved version of the older Quarrymaster series. Now I'll take and show you around a little bit. The DM3 had a bit loading of 30,000 pounds. You can see the mast leaned back over the drill there, which is what the steels are connected to. The drill head on a DM3 was either a model DRD or a DRD2. Right back here, this big tank you see is the hydraulic oil tank. And right here, you can see the gauge to tell the operator what the oil level is in the tank, if it's low or high. Under here, you can get a view of the big chain running around the sprocket, which connects up to the drive motor to travel the machine. One bad thing about these older Drillmaster series was that they were bad at supplying direct drill power on the rotary head. There's four jack pads on a DM3. Two in the front and two in the back. This pipe you see right here connects to the dust collector, which is right here on this side of the drill. This is basically designed to collect the dust when the drill would be drilling so that there wasn't much dust and debris flying around. Inside here, you can get a view of where the dust would go down and then come out on a pile alongside the drill. Notice that the crawler pads on this drill are very narrow. A lot of these smaller blast drills always have very narrow pads, and the reason for that is because these machines are designed to be working on shot rock or uneven ground. Wider crawler pads are prone to bending, twisting, or breaking if the machine is working on uneven ground or shot rock. So narrow pads are better suited for the material that this machine is working on. Right here, you can see one of your other jack pads in the rear. Inside here, you can get a view of the engine. This drill is powered by a GM 671 diesel, and it connects to the hydraulic pump to create hydraulic power for this machine. This entire drill is all hydraulic power to work the jack pads and to raise and lower the mast. Right here on the back is the cover for your radiator, and right up here on the top you can see the original logo, the IR symbol for Ingersoll Rand. As you can see, this is not a very large blast drill, but keep in mind that back in the 1930s and 1940s, a lot of the blast hole drills were relatively small on this scale. The reason for that was because hydraulic equipment back then for mining and quarry applications was also a lot smaller. Right here is your fuel tank for the engine. Here's another view of the GM diesel right inside there. And you can see the gauges to monitor the engine and the radiator fan in the back there. Now, these Drillmasters originally were designed with compressors ranging up to about 900 CFM. But later on, Ingersoll Rand would replace the older compressors with a new screw design compressor. Here you can get a view of the superstructure, which runs across there to support the weight of the engine, the body, and the whole mast for this machine. This is part of the hydraulic system you see right here, which takes all your fluid power from your pumps to the hand levers, which connect to the valves right here to work this machine. Now I'll take you up inside the cab. Thank you. Here's the operator station on the DM3. Take note that the cab is very narrow. A lot of these older drills had very small cabs on them. Right out in front here is where all your gauges would be, and you can see all the original hand levers to work this machine when it would be running. Take note that the case for one of the jack pads is also inside the cab. This window you see here off to my left is actually where the operator would be focusing the majority of his attention when the machine would be in the drilling process, to watch the steel and to control the feed and the rotation. Also take notice that the seat to work this drill lifts up and folds down so the operator can get in and out of the cab. And on the front, you can see the original sign that says Ingersoll Rand Drill Master. But there she is, an Ingersoll Rand DM3 Blast Drill.